It's now close to 6 months since the public witnessed ugly scenes in the districts of Mitiana, Hoima, Soroti and Buvuma when security agencies dispersed Women's Day celebrations organized by opposition female legislators. This was escalated by chaos at the main gate of parliament when the same legislators were stopped from marching to the Ministry of Internal Affairs to present their petition over mistreatment and arrogance of RDCs in the above-mentioned districts.
Don't fight!
Today, the Presidential Affairs Committee kicked off an inquiry into the matter with testimonies from victims.
Of the security officers, UPDF and the police in blocking Women's Day celebrations are illegal, irrational, and atrocious, and constitute an affront on the right to association and assemble enshrined in Article 29 of the Constitution.
Opposition female members of Parliament, led by Joyce Bagala, demonstrated to the Presidential Affairs Committee of Parliament, led by Jessica Ababiku, on how they were manhandled and bundled in police vans, where they witnessed horrible scenes.
The security officers from the UPDF and police stormed the venue, confronted the Honorable Susan Mugabe, together with other invitees, beat them up and tear gassed whoever was around, and blocked the Women's Day celebrations. As a result of the security officer's actions, the Honorable Susan sustained injuries to the extent that she was admitted to the hospital.
As Nurse Nyakato, the woman member of parliament for Hoima City, could not control her emotions while narrating events on the fateful day. She noted that she was harassed and embarrassed by police officers who fondled her breasts.
Some of them are mothers. The torture that they inflicted on us members of parliament speaks louder, speaks volume.
MPs decried the impunity of RDCs, who tend to dictate which activities take place in their districts using their political powers. MPs also demanded that the RDCs and DPCs implicated should be apprehended.
Officers, RDCs and RCCs involved in the assault of all the affected members of parliament be prosecuted personally before courts of law. Security agencies be restrained, stopped and prevented from blocking Women's Day celebrations or any other meeting and assembly permitted by law.
Committee members now want the political heads in respective ministries to appear and explain where these police officers and RDCs get their commands.
Investigation by the committee will look at the holistic behaviors of the RDCs across the country. It is not only from these particular constituencies whom the petition has brought forward, but there are other districts also with RDCs who are actually acting outside their mandate. They are becoming too political, they are becoming partisan.
The committee will also investigate several instances where these opposition women legislators have clashed with RDCs and some police officers who blocked Women's Day celebrations in their districts.
As a starting point, we shall prioritize in-depth investigation in the districts mentioned so that we shall be able to understand why all the things mentioned have occurred.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.